Oh, thank you, Millvina. No, I didn't know. I didn't want to bother you because I'm thinking that you're always busy with visitors and different people always wanting to come see you because of the Titanic and different things.
I know, but I'm recording who it is.
Yeah, yeah.
If it's somebody, and I like you, so.
Well, thank you.
if it's somebody, no, most people are nice. There's only one odd one. That's one thing, I can't drink water.
Oh, you don't drink water? No.
Never drink water. Oh. It was funny. I was at the big Maritime Museum in London for a week. There was a very big exhibition, and they asked me there, and I stayed for a week, and I was being interviewed and everything by and photographed by all the world. And it was quite hectic, lovely, I loved it. And then the director said one evening he wanted to take us out to quite an expensive place for dinner. So Bruno and I went along, and water was put on the table, you see, a jug of water, and he was pouring me out some. I said, oh no, thank you. And he said, don't you drink water, Millvina? I said, no. He said, but it's so good for you. And I said, Richard, my aunt is now 100, my mother died at 95, my grandmother, my great aunt was 99, my grandmother was 90, and they never drank water in their lives. You offer my grandmother water, you say, water? You don't drink it, you wash with it. And so I've never had water. But and it can't be that bad for you, can it?
No, it's good.
But I mean, it's tasteless. Oh. I don't mind it with orange juice or something.
Okay.
Or some kind of fruit juice, yes. But plain water, no.
I drink lots of water.
Comes down water. And they always have it on the tables in restaurants, everybody, because everybody drinks water.
Yeah.
I've discovered, except me.
You say you don't drink it because it's tasteless. Is it just because it's tasteless, or...
Mm-hmm.
You say you don't drink water because it's tasteless. Do you just don't drink it because it's tasteless, or because...
I don't like it. It's no taste. Yeah. I mean, there's nothing to it to me.
Okay.
Unless you have, say, orange juice, I like...
Yeah.
I like water with orange or water with any fruit.
Because some people who might hear that might think, oh, she doesn't want to drink water because of the Titanic or something, you know?
Oh, nothing like that.
Yeah.
Oh, no, there was something quite funny because I belong to say it for fun because somebody said something about an ice cream. Would you like an ice cream or something? And I said, oh, no, I don't want an ice cream. What should I say? I don't want anything with ice because of the Titanic. And I only said it for more or less fun. But it was in all the papers the next day. Millvina won't have anything with ice because of the Titanic.
No.
And it really wasn't that at all.
Yeah, sometimes papers do that. Yeah.
Yes, well, yeah.
Do you have things with ice in it? Like we have like orange juice and have ice in it?
Oh, no, I don't have ice in anything. I don't like it.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that's partly another thing, you see. I said I never have ice in anything.
Yes.
And I might have said then because of the Titanic, but I don't like ice. And in America, of course, it's all ice, isn't it? Of course, you're not American. You're Canadian, I forgot that. I think all the time you're an American. Because they have ice with everything, don't they?
Yeah, pretty much, yeah.
Yeah, I see. I remember when I first went, when the immigration man let us out and the Americans were waiting, and we were going to a hotel to meet the others. And the first thing, they said, now, I expect you'd like a cup of hot tea, would you? Well, tea's automatically hot. I said, hot tea? Yes, well, but I said, but tea is hot. Well, apparently in America it's not. So I said, I would have some, please. And it was the most dreadful tea. It was so weak, couldn't stand up in the cup. In the end, I was having four tea bags in my cup in America. They make the most dreadful tea.
Huh.
Dreadful.
What do you drink?
Do you see my bar around there?
That's funny. That is funny. I gotta get a picture of that.
But I do drink tea, I must admit.
Yeah.
I like tea.
Right on. Oh, you got all kinds of stuff there.
Yeah.
Right on. Baileys. You like Baileys? Yeah, Baileys
is
good.
Well, very much the Irish. You've had it, have you?
Oh, yes, I have. Yeah, we got that in Canada.
That's nice.
Yeah. filmmaking process and everything. Oh, yeah.
That must be very interesting.
It is interesting. I love it. Yeah, I love lovely. It. Yeah. You know, it's a real struggle sometimes to get the shots you want, but once you get those shots, it's like putting your dreams on screen. It's one of the greatest feelings. Yeah. And you know, 50, 100 years from now, I'm gone. My films are still out there.
Oh, of course, yes. Yeah,
and it's kind of like making my mark in life.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
Pick Me Up, it was called, a magazine. Mm-hmm. And they came here and interviewed me, but it wasn't me at all. I mean, it was all wrong.
Yeah, yes. I know. Newspapers and press will do that. They'll add things or give half-truths and or blow things up bigger than they actually are.
You see, it just wasn't me.
Right.
But it was already out, the magazine, so we couldn't do anything about it, of course.
Hmm. Yeah, it's too bad. Yeah, I've had some experience with that. I know how newspapers are. What was your favorite film that you ever watched?
My favorite film?
Yeah, your favorite movie.
I like the old-fashioned ones, like Pride and Prejudice, Jane Eyre, all those. Gone with the Wind.
Gone with the Wind.
Those, yes.
Yeah. Did you ever see Grand Hotel? Greta Garbo?
Oh, yes.
John Barrymore?
Yeah. Oh, yes, I saw her in one or two. Yes, and Grand Hotel I liked.
Yes, yeah. It was one of my favorites, too.
One of your favorites, yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
But I remember seeing an American one called My Sister Eileen. Did you ever see it?
No, I haven't, no.
But I thought it was excellent. But I saw it again and didn't have the same effect.
Hmm.
At the time, I thought it was ever so funny.
Yeah.
But when I saw it the second time, it wasn't the same.
I'll have to check that out.
Yeah.
Who's your favorite actor or your favorite actress?
Well, it's the old ones. None of these are my favorites.
Right.
Not the recent ones. Well, yes, there's one I like. Can't remember his name. I know it was a film, Dancing with Wolves.
Oh, Kevin Costner.
Was that who he was?
Yeah, Kevin Costner.
I liked him very much.
That's
I liked that film. And I liked him very much.
Yeah.
And I liked all the cowboy films. And I liked, of course, all the handsome old ones. The one that was in Gone with the Wind, Clark Gable.
Right, yeah.
And, but they were... I think much more handsome than the ones now. Now, I did like one, Mrs. Brown. Did you ever see that one?
I don't believe so, no.
Well,
you're naming some films I'm going to have to check out now.
That was an English one.
Okay.
But, and they were English. Oh, yes, they were English actor and actresses. And it was an excellent, I saw it on the QE too. And it was an extremely good film. But one of the few recent ones that's, you know, I mean, more or less up-to-date ones that I liked, because they were, but mind you, the old-fashioned ones that they make now, I like. Wuthering Heights, Jane Eyre,
okay,
all that kind of thing, I like those best, mm-hmm. The old-fashioned ones.
Yeah.
But we're old-fashioned, but with the but today's actors and actresses in, but really, they were good.
Yeah.
They were sort of real people. The ones now, well, I don't know.
Yeah.
Not at all good.
Yeah. Yeah. You said you used to like old westerns. You mean like John Wayne, Gary Cooper?
Oh, yeah, John Wayne.
Yeah.
And just, who's my favourite? The Fisherman. Don't know if you ever saw it. It was an excellent film. He had a fishing boat. And there was a child that the parents couldn't do anything with. And so they put him on this boat to be looked after by this captain. And he was a most dreadful little boy, but in the end, he was ever so good. But he didn't want to go back to his parents. He liked... Now, who on earth was that man? Well, I like Catherine Hepburn. The African Queen. Did you see that?
With Humphrey Bogart.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I saw that.
That's
sorry.
Good.
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Yes.
But this fishing one, what on earth... Who on earth was this man? Cool, he was so good. Not handsome, but very, very good. One of my favourites. Catherine Hepburn also is one of my favourites.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did you ever see High Noon with Grace Kelly and Gary Cooper?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, that was good.
Yeah, that was good.
Very, had you on your toes wondering what was going to happen. And I always remember one film with, now that Italian actress, she was quite lovely. Not Sophia Loren. Another one, I don't know if you know the Italian, did you know the Italian actresses?
No, I don't, unfortunately, no.
Well, this was a most exciting film, but the fun thing was that she was being attacked by somebody, and there was a dog tied up, and the whole crowd in the film, in the audience, shouted, "Let the dog go!" And then, of course, everybody was spoiled. It spoiled, really, the horror of the film, because it's funny, we all did it spontaneously, said, "Let the dog go." I should never forget that. And it was so funny that everybody would say that at the same time, because the dog was tied up. So how she could, I don't know what happened, because everybody laughed so much then, that it really spoiled the film. You know, there was no more horror.
Yeah.
I always remember that.
Did you ever have a favourite TV show? Did you ever have a favourite TV show that you like to watch? Like, did you ever watch things like the Beverly Hillbillies or anything like
that? Well, at the moment, I'm watching a talent show that they're finding talent in England.
Britain's Got Talent?
Have you watched this?
Yes, it's very good.
Did you see that dog?
The dog with the girl?
Yeah.
Yes, I saw that, yes.
Wasn't it fantastic?
Yeah, yeah, they're very talented. Are those two kids, the Cheeky Monkeys?
Oh, they're good.
Yeah.
They were lovely
kids. 8, 9 years old, that's excellent.
They're lovely kids.
Yeah.
And the Saturday evening, see, they're going to say who's won.
Right.
And yeah. I hope it's the children.
Yeah.
They were absolutely lovely.
Over the years, like, if you're watching a TV program or like you're switching channels, for example, and there was something on the Titanic, would you stop and watch it?
No.
No? Okay.
No, I don't watch anything on Titanic.
Right. If there was an article in a magazine or a newspaper, would you read it?
Yes, I probably would if it was in a paper, yeah. Because I want to know what it was about.
Right.
Yes,
right.
And who it was about.
Did you ever watch any movies about the Titanic?
No.
Okay, A Night to Remember or the James Cameron?
Yes, we did watch one in America.
Okay.
Four survivors. We didn't want to go on the lease, but we really had no choice. And we saw this one. Well, at least I probably shut my eyes half the time. But we all hated it. And one person said she couldn't sleep for weeks after because of seeing that one. It was a nightmare.
Right. That was A Night to Remember, I think that was, when the...
The first, A Night to Remember was the first one, wasn't it?
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, the first major one.
Well, everybody asks me what I think the most important things are. I've been asked so many times at various, what's it called, conferences and things. And I say, a kind heart and a sense of humour. I think those are the most important things. I've met literally thousands of people.
Yeah.
All nationalities, rich and poor.
Yeah.
And there was, I was told, because so many people, directly I arrived at a place, I'm surrounded, especially in America. The Americans are obsessed with the Titanic.
Yeah.
And the people said to me, "Don't you hate all these people surrounding you?" And I said, "No, I like people. I do.
Yes,
all people.
Yes.
Yeah, it's just my nature."
How do you feel about them? There was talk about them raising a part of the Titanic or the hull part of the Titanic. How do you feel about them?
About what?
How do you feel about salvagers going down there to get pieces from the Titanic or debris, you know,
I watched one film when they were getting things, but they were all off the Titanic, on the seabed.
Right.
So that was okay, they were on the seabed, you see. Also, if they go down and get them for museums, it's not so bad, because I think it's a part of history. So I don't. It's the people who go down to make money out of it.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Those are the ones I think awful. Are awful. But the ones who get them and put them in museums for historical values, I think that is more or less all right.
If you had an opportunity to take a deep sea dive down to visit the wreck of the Titanic, would you go?
No, I wouldn't. I was asked to go.
Oh, you were asked to go?
Yes.
Okay.
Would I go down in one of those submersibles?
Yes.
And I said, not for £1 million. And they said, we wouldn't pay you that much. Mind you, they would have paid me a lot for the publicity, I bet. But I said, no, of course I wouldn't. And they said, well, I can't understand, you're going up in a plane. I said, well, a plane's different. A plane, you can see the sky. As long as I see the sky, okay. But as for going down, oh, dreadful. Would you go down?
Probably I would. Just out of curiosity, just to
Oh, no, I couldn't. The minute I went under, I was under the sea. Oh, I'd start screaming. I know me. No, I wouldn't have done it for anything. It's my father, I think he was a hero. Because directly he heard the tragedy, ever so many people thought, oh, it's unsinkable. So that they weren't bothered. The ship won't go down, they thought. But my father wasn't taking a chance. Right. He had us up on deck as quick as possible and into the lifeboat.
Yes.
Yeah.
He acted very smart and very fast.
Yeah. My father was going to have us back in the shop. And we had a house waiting for us. And I've seen the house. I went to Kansas. I was invited there by a friend. So we went and stayed in Kansas for a fortnight. And he said, would you like to see the house you would have lived in? And I said, yes. It was a lovely house.
Yeah.
Yes, lovely. And the people who were there, my relations had it until 5 years before we went there. It had been owned by my relations for a long time. And then they sold it to these, well, presumably they sold it to these people. And these people were extremely nice. They were waiting for us with champagne and all kinds of little fancy things to eat. They were extremely nice people.
Yeah. If you could summarize the whole Titanic tragedy and how it affected so many people's lives, what would you say?
Well, I'm a person who believes in fate. What is to be will be.
Right.
I mean, and you can do nothing about it.
Right.
I mean, it's all, well, it's all, as I say, it's all fate.
Right.
So, I wouldn't have known, I wouldn't have done anything about it. I would have thought, well, it's happened, so that's it.
Yeah. When you say fate, do you believe everything's in God's hands?
Well, yeah, more or less, yes.
Yes.
Of course, yes.
Yes. Okay.
My father was a very handsome man.
Yes, yeah.
And my mother was so broken-hearted, she never speak about it.
Okay, yeah.
And I knew nothing about it until I was 8 years old.
Right, right.
And besides, I always looked on my grandfather as my father. You see, I always looked on him as my father, my grandfather.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yes, no, I understand. Yes, I understand.
So, to me, he was my father.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Did your mother ever speak like about being on the Titanic boat? It was like sailing on it, or
I never heard anything about it until I was 8 years old. She was going to get married again.
Right.
And all she told me is what happened the night the ship was struck by the iceberg.
Right.
And she just said that time, they all heard a crash, and my father said he'd go up and see what had happened, came back and said apparently the ship had struck an iceberg. Get the children, that was my brother and myself, out of bed as quick as possible and up on deck. And I think that saved us, because ever so many third-class passengers went down with the ship.
Right.
And because the first and second-class passengers came first.
Throughout the years, did you ever have any bad feelings or blame anyone for the sinking?
No. Like, yes, I would. I blame the captain.
Yes.
Oh,
okay.
Yes, because he shouldn't have been in there. He shouldn't have been so near the icebergs.
Right, and going at that fast a speed with warnings.
I think they were in an awful hurry to beat the record.
Right.
And I think he'd been warned that they were near the icebergs, but they still went on, and of course went into one. I definitely would say the captain was to blame.
Right. Okay.
But I mean, I don't. Of course, you don't know. That's the thing.
Yeah.
What happened when she got on in the lifeboat? She found that she had me, but not my brother. But she couldn't do anything about it. Of course, it was bitterly cold night, and she had to try to keep me warm.
Right. Well, lowered down, it was...
I was put in a sack and put overboard, yeah.
Okay.
Because I was so small, they couldn't hold me.
Right,
So, so I was put in a sack. And she had no idea what happened to him until we were picked up by the Carpathia. And then a passenger, whether it was the same lifeboat as us, I don't know, but there was another passenger who looked after him. And he was all right.
Okay.
So that was a great relief for my mother, of course.
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
Huh. Why did your mother take you and your brother back to England after the sinking? Like, she's already in New York. Why didn't she go off to Kansas?
Oh, no, there's no point. She didn't want to. She was broken-hearted. She didn't want to stay in America. We had relations, but we didn't know them. We'd only seen them once. And all she wanted to do, obviously, was get home.
If you had to live your life over again, is there anything you'd do differently?
Oh, I do a lot differently. I wouldn't be as I used to be. You wouldn't believe it. As a child, I stuttered most dreadfully, and I was dreadfully shy. Oh, no, I do things quite differently.
Me too, I was shy too, so welcome to the club.
I wouldn't do the things I did.
Yeah.
Not if I was again, because, I don't know, various things should have been changed. Because I've hurt one or two people, but not on purpose, but I know I've hurt them. And I feel awful, when I look back, I feel awful about that, because they were extremely nice people. Anyhow, I won't go thinking about that. And baby,
I've got you. Baby. I've got you, babe.
Got you, babe. It's gorgeous.
Yes, it is.
Gorgeous, yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't look as if he switched off. He's not talking.
Okay. Oh, there we go. Play sunshine. Dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. My only sunshine, you make me happy when skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. You know, Belfast.
He's lovely too.
Yeah, that's
great. Now that reminds me of years ago. When my aunt died, she was getting on for 90. 10 years ago, perhaps.
Huh, so you didn't know what your father looked like till 10 years ago?
I had no idea at all. Yeah. No, not the faintest idea. Huh. Never saw a picture of him.
Yeah.